Where is the love? Last weekend, I took a quick trip to Sedona, Arizona, a short 2-hour drive from where I currently live. I couldn't help but to notice something very different during this visit. There seemed to be a reoccurring theme of heart-shaped objects, symbols, and signs everywhere I went. Without looking for them, I would see a heart-shaped rock, drawing, cloud, tree, even someone's garbage was somehow formed into the shape of a heart. It quickly became a delightful game as I would search for the next heart and smile each time one was discovered. Towards the end of my trip, I found myself in a silent meditation near a smooth river at Buddha Beach, just under Cathedral Rock. It was dusk, the air was gentle, the sounds of the forest were changing from busy daytime birds to evening crickets and croaking frogs. I asked my angels, "What's with all the hearts?" Their answer took me deep within myself into a small and sweet journey of realization, and I'd like to take you on that journey in this week's blog. "When you are open to love, you will see evidence of it everywhere you go," my angels began. I settled myself against a tree in their lovely presence and readying myself to be taught. You see, when you have walls around your heart, it is as though you have filters in front of your awareness. Heart walls filter out your ability to see love in all of its forms and in all of its truth. Love could be standing right in front of you. People could be speaking to you in loving ways. The universe could be offering you heaps and heaps of love. But because your heart walls are filtering, you will not see what is really happening around you. I took a moment to let this set in. Could it be possible that there is much more love in this world than we can perceive? My angels continued, "Yes. That is the way most people function, and so they see the world as though they are wearing dark sunglasses. They can't see the magnitude of light around them, even if it is being given by another person." This made me sad. No wonder there are so many miscommunications in our world. A question came to mind, and so I asked, "What causes us to put up such thick walls around our hearts?" "Many reasons," they replied, "but mostly you believe it is for your self-preservation. When you become hurt, your first inclination is to defend yourself against more hurt. Completely justified and understandable, we angels always want you to feel safe. However, the method that you use to keep yourself protected shuts out the entire world, including love. This causes you to feel more separated, alone, unsupported, and as we have discussed, it limits your ability to see the world as it truly is. When your perception becomes so dark, it is hard to let down those walls because you think you would be letting them down while existing in a dark, loveless world. Nothing could be further from the truth." They paused, letting my mind whirl through my own experiences of feeling unsafe and unloved. I remembered back on times in my life when I felt exceptionally isolated, depressed, and like I didn't want to be in this world anymore. I wondered, had there been love around me then? Answering my thoughts, my angels replied, "Yes, there has always been love around you." I could see in my intuition a vision of my past self many years ago, crying on my bedroom floor, suffering with so much emotional pain, and I was begging God for help. What I couldn't see then was what I was able to see now, that I was literally being held by hundreds of angels, as if God himself had me in the palm of his hand. There was so much light around me, but my heart was so walled up that I couldn't see it or feel it. The isolation I felt was due to too many heart walls filtering out love. My angels continued softly as they knew I was feeling vulnerable with this memory. "You walled off your heart and couldn't feel love because you perceived that love is what hurt you. But now you understand that love never hurt you. Life wasn't working out the way you wanted it to. People let you down. Your body was letting you down. It was the lack of love that hurt you. Darling, love has always been here to heal you." Blinking back moist eyes, I replied, "Yes, I know this now. My journey into the mystical realms has taught me a lot about love, what it is and what it is not." "Thus," they answered, "your heart walls have dissolved. You are open to see love wherever you go. You discovered that an open heart is the only way to live because it is the only way you will perceive this world in truth. You have learned to feel safe surrounded by love instead of shielding yourself against it. And because I'm no longer protecting myself against love, I replied, I am able to see signs of it everywhere I go. There was an air of silent understanding as I sat and continued thinking about how I have been functioning lately. A couple years ago, I realized that I wasn't really afraid to love. I was afraid of people. It took me a long time to realize that harmful relationships don't represent what love is. They represent what love is not. My healing needed to be around relationships, not love itself. But when we are hurt, we cast love aside when we should be running back towards it. We swear off love when we should be recommitting to it. Love is the answer because the lack of love caused the problem. Love has the power to protect you while allowing you to perceive the world in its true form. When we are willing to exchange walls for more love, we start to trust love. Once we begin to truly understand what love is and what it is not, we open ourselves to understanding the entire universe. You are love, my angels gently re-entered my thoughts. Love is your nature. Love is not about someone. It is not relationship specific. You could simply be loving with everything around you, and that is how you should be with your entire existence. Love is your quality. You can touch everything and everyone lovingly because love is who you are. Love is not about anyone else. You can walk down the street lovingly. You can do your work lovingly. It is the very way you are when you have no heart walls. And when you understand this, that love is not something you attain or get from anyone else, that it truly is your nature, you will never experience a lack of love. You will never be afraid of it, no matter how you are relating to others. I whispered softly, I am the love that I see reflecting back to me from the world. As if on cue, a majestic caw from a nearby crow affirmed my statement. If you are willing and ready to dissolve your heart walls, you will begin to see evidence of love everywhere you go too. Take the symbols of love that you see in the world as an indication that you are on the right track to having less filters. Then one day you'll see it was there all along. Love, its nature, unconditional, never, ever leaves you, because you are love. May you see evidence of it everywhere you go.